Take out that list.
So it wasn't a nightmare?
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How do you feel?
I'm cold. What are we gonna do now?
That android we saw yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. The train passes just on the other side of the road. The station can't be far. You feel okay to walk a little? Let's go then.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
Well, we'll go that way, so.
Police are on our trail.
All right. That's all for now. Free to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
Took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Maybe.
All right, gotta reach the train station. Right, let's get past cop. Walk right past him. This is all different now.
Shit, that's them! Stop, police!
We saw them headed for the train station.
Oh my goodness. I gotta catch them.
over there!
Don't shoot! We need it alive!
That's insane.
Hey, where are you going?
I can't let them get away.
They won't. They'll never make it to the other side.
I can't take that chance.
Now you will get yourself killed. Do not go after him, Connor! God damn it!
Good. Well, that didn't work out too good. Well, actually, it kind of did, I guess. Let's check the world stats and see what happened. Oh, 60%. She made it across by 60%. Interesting. I wonder what happened if...
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
Because of the flow chart with this, I'll go back here to the main menu. What, wait a minute. What section is this? Jericho, okay. Okay. Jericho has no really different changes. I completed 93% of that. There's really nothing that's going to be different with that, so we'll go back to the chapter. Jericho. The Nest. What is that all about? Yeah, the Nest. Okay, so lunch break with Hank. Talk to Hank, and none of that went well at all. So well, let's see. See how our lunch break with Hank goes.
Ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
I thought now might be a good time to review what we know about deviants.
No, now is not a good time to review anything. Now is my lunch break. So just go into standby and cut me some slack, okay?
Here you go.
Hygiene, huh?
Thanks, Gary. I'm starving.
Don't leave that thing here.
Oh, not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
Your meal meal contains 1.4 times the recommended daily intake of calories, and twice the cholesterol level. You shouldn't eat that.
Everybody's got to die of something.
Do you eat here often?
Most days. Gary makes the best burger in Detroit.
This morning, when we were chasing those deviants, why didn't you want me to cross the highway?
Because you could have been killed. I don't like filling out paperwork for damaged equipment.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl.
Yep.
I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I think working with an officer with personal issues is an added challenge. But adapting to human unpredictability is one of my features. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. You should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Connor, you run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Now, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding
feathers.
An LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops. Hey, were you really making a report back there in the elevator? Just by closing your eyes?
Correct.
Shit. Wish I could do that.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
Jesus, this place stinks.
Looks like we came for nothing. Okay. Our man's gone.
Nothing there. Urban Forms Depot.
Fresh air. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable.
That's just nasty.
Ah, Jesus, I hate these things.
RT. Probably initials.
Put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
Real books. Thought I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some.
Electronic books, you can't... smell the paper. See the pages turning yellow. Yeah.
You have no idea what I'm talking about, do you?
Okay. He removes his chip just like Alice did. Or Kara did.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons.
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something.
Okay. missing something. Missing. Ah, there it is. There we go. Someone in the living room. He's still here. Gotta be somewhere. All about. I left the bathroom, living room. There he is. There you are. Well, peekaboo. Go. No. Go. Catch him. Oh, yes.
Holy shit.
Right.
Please. I've done nothing wrong. I just wanted to be free. You know what they'll do to me if you turn me in.
Model 874004961. Serious malfunctions have been detected in your software, including class 4 errors.
I caught them. See what happens.
You've been deemed defective and will be sent back to CyberLife for deactivation.
Don't you fucking move. You bastard. You saw I was gonna fall and you'd rather let me die than fail your fucking mission.
I had to make a choice. It seemed to me...
What am I to you? A statistic? A zero? A one in your fucking program? Huh? Is that how you see humans, you bastard? Jesus.
I understand you're upset. Perhaps I didn't assess the
situation...
Fuck
you and your fucking assessment. Come here.
Are you doing this?
All right.
You're one of us.
Shut up.
You're helping humans. But you're just their slave.
I said shut up! All right. Come along.
All right, now you save me.
Hey, what the fuck? Holy shit. Fucking androids.
Oh, that didn't go too well. I caught him. How many people caught him? Oh, hey, everybody caught him. I'm sorry, no. Everybody got away. From last time, I missed them last time, but 21% this time caught them, and it chose to let Hank hang, like I did. So that's funny. So, well, that's cool. That works. Let's see, so that's a good thing for that. since I unlock that and save that. Does that change this timeline? No, it doesn't change that timeline. Mosquito? Got mosquito in the house. That's a lot of options with this. Well, I think I'm going to end it right there. But let's see if I got anything new. Looks like I might have something new. Magazines. I think the magazine I found and picked up. The way they did this. Different kind of tech magazines I picked up on the way to store the line. It's still some rare magazines I can unlock that I haven't found yet, so. Yeah, that's the one I picked up. This is cool. I like the way they've done this. I think it's in conjunction with what the storyline is. So if I go up, maybe go up. See where it gets me. So that's a magazine I picked up. That's cool. That's that blue blood they were talking about. Trilithium. Trium, excuse me. Terrarium 310, I guess it's called. Yeah. Therium 310. Excuse me. Therium 310. I can't see. This is a very well thought out game. And I like it. So. Alright. And let's check out some of the videos.